पुराने जमाने के
टीचिंग के तरीकों से
हमको क्यों पढ़ाते हैं, इट्स सो बोरिंग।
अब वेदांतु देगा प्रॉब्लम से छुटकारा।
हाय किड्स,
हेलो टीचर। आएगा तो मजा आएगा तो समझ आएगा।
बेस्ट टीचर्स पढ़ाए तो सिंपल लगे एवरीथिंग।
लीडर बोर्ड्स एंड क्विज़ेस से
अमेजिंग।
समझ आएगा तो
Vedantu, learn live online. To attend a free live class, download the app now.
Hey guys, very good evening to all of you once again. Welcome back to the sessions. Hi and how are you all? जल्दी बता दो, खाना वाना खा लिया कि नहीं? सब सेट है? And did you like Abhishek sir's session or not? चलो, so very good evening to all of you. चलो शुरू करते हैं with Applications of Trigonometry. तो Application of Trigonometry अपन करेंगे and today itself we will be completing it. तो let's start. Sit tight. We are going to have lot of questions and it is going to be super duper awesome. तो शुरू करते हैं. Let's start our today's session. Applications of Trigonometry. Now you are having my session. So after this there will be no session. सो जाना आराम से. Again tomorrow I'll again come in front of all of you at 7 o'clock. And tomorrow we'll do with circles part. So please do not miss that. Tomorrow also at 7 o'clock, be there. Okay? Chalo, shuru karte hain. This is the whole schedule. Right now we are standing at here. Circle, sorry, not standing here. 26th November, it's 9 o'clock. So we are standing at here. 27th November, tomorrow we'll have 7 o'clock circles. Okay? So don't forget to come. Now moving on. So we are going to cover all these topics today. Height and distances problems, problems on angle of elevation, angle of depression. This is the only thing. So in this chapter particularly, theory is very less. But type of questions are very much. So we are going to see all of them. One by one and very fastly with some very outstanding tips and tricks. Tricks predominantly with which we can actually solve them easily. Much more easily. Just like what we did in the previous session. Chalo, here is the first question for all of you. Please pay attention. The first question says, the angle of depression of a car parked on the road from the top 150 meter high tower is 30 degree. 150 meter high tower, there is a car parked on the road. Someone is looking. Always remember, depression means downwards. From your level, from your horizontal level, it will be always downwards. Depression and elevation is always upwards. So someone on the top is looking at the car. So this is the car. Okay, now 150 meter high, fine. This is 90 degree because we assume that the building is straight perpendicular. And 30 degree is the angle of depression. So from here, if I take it as 30 degree, this will be 30 degree. Okay, and the distance of the car from the tower is? Distance of the car from the tower, we have to find this. D, this distance has to be found. I guess you all get it that if this is 30 degree, angle of depression was this from the horizontal, the angle of line of sight from the horizontal. So this is 30 degree. So this will be 30 degree and alternate interior angles. If this is 30 degree, this front side will be perpendicular. So now let me apply tan. So it is tan 30, which is perpendicular 150 divided by base. Base is D. You all know tan 30 is nothing but 1 by root 3. Do the cross multiplication. You will get D is equals to 150 root 3 and this is the value. Okay, so that's all for this question and it's a pretty easy question. 2 marks you can expect very easily. Okay, even it can come in 1 mark also, but very less chances from this chapter. 1 marker is less chances. Okay, so we got this answer, 150 root 3 meters. Okay, now there is one more doubt for all of the students in this particular chapter, that sir, do we need to calculate the final value? Final value calculate karna hai kya? 150 root 3 ki value 1.732, do we need to put that and get the final value? I would say not required until and unless it is specifically mentioned in the question. So say for example, here the question could have mentioned, find the distance of the car correct up to 2 decimal places or 1 decimal places. This means question is saying that you have to put the value. Or sometimes it happens that specifically it is mentioned that root 3 is 1.732 in the question itself. This means you have to put the value. Otherwise not required. So don't make your whole work clumsy. Okay, moving on. Here is the next question then. The solution for this question is this 150 root 3. We got the value. Here is the next question then. From the top of a cliff 20 meter in height, the elevation of the top of a tower is found to be equal to the angle of depression of the foot of the tower. Okay, so there is a 20, okay, wait a second. There is a 20 meter high cliff. The elevation of the top of a tower, okay. So it says that there is a tower on the ground. Elevation, always remember, it will be considered from the horizontal. So the angle of elevation of the top of the tower, may it be theta. This is found to be equal to the angle of depression. So here, if it is written only the elevation, do not get confused. It is saying angle of elevation. Okay. So the angle of elevation is same equal to the angle of depression of the foot of the tower. So if someone looks at the foot of the tower, still the angle of depression is also same, theta. Okay. Now what the question says, so this is a 90 degree, fine. So if this is a 90 degree, see, there could be multiple methods for this. One is trigonometry. So we are studying trigonometry, I'll tell you, but there is an easier method also. And there is nowhere written in the board examination or any other pattern that you have to solve it using trigonometry only. What you can do here, you are able to see that if you name this A, B, C, D, E. So if you name this, you will be able to see that this is the 90 degree. Okay. And theta equal. So angle side angle, because side is common, you can actually prove these two triangles congruent. Okay. In one step. So if they are congruent, very easily you can write that this BC is equal to this part. And what is the length of BC? Very easily from here only you can get it 20. So it is also 20. If this is 20, then surely this is also 20. Height of the tower, without even using trigonometry, we got it 40. Okay. So in case if it comes in a MCQ, you can do it like this without any way. Even if it comes in two marker where you have to explain, you can explain it like this. Not at all any problem. Now, in case if you want to go with the other method, so that method will include trigonometry, where you will apply tan theta, and tan theta is equals to perpendicular, so that is AB upon base is BE, and then you will again apply tan theta for this triangle, small lower triangle. Here also you will write tan theta perpendicular, that is 20 upon base BE. So now you will make both of them equal, and from here you will get that AB is 20. So that is also a method. You can go with either one of them. Okay. Now, if you all understood that, let's move ahead. Here is the next one. This is the whole solution. Okay. Not this one. Sorry. 20. So value, this is 20. So this will be also 20, and hence the final value 40 meter. They have done such a long thing, isn't it? And we have done it very easily. Moving on, this is the next question. Next question says, it's a very famous question and you can expect it in your examination because it's a very favorite question for the boards. Tree breaks down. Okay. So this tree wind problem, where there is a tree standing on the ground and thereafter some wind comes and it breaks it from between, somewhere middle. So what we do whenever the tree gets broken, so say for example it is broken from here, so it will fall down on the ground like this, and now it will form a triangle. So this is the question. Now a tree breaks due to storm, broken part bends so that the top of the tree touches the ground, making an angle 30 degree with it. Means this part is making an angle 30 degree with the ground, the top of the tree. Distance between the foot of the tree and the point where the top touches the ground is 8 meter. Means this distance is given 8 meters. Okay. So this distance is 8. Fine. Now what else? Find the height of the tree. Okay. Let's find that. For finding the height, I have to find this portion also and this portion also. And this portion is the same, this hypotenuse. So I will take it as A, this as B, and this as C. Okay. Now if I take all these three sides, A, B, C, I will just apply the trigonometry. I will write tan 30, which is equals to perpendicular AB upon base is BC, which is 8. So I'll just write the values tan 30 1 by root 3, AB upon BC is nothing but 8. So do the cross multiplication, you will get 8 by root 3. So 8 by root 3 is the value of AB. But in the same fashion, I need the value of AC also. So if base is given 8, and I need the hypotenuse, I guess you all will be able to understand, we will apply cos. So in the exactly same fashion as we get 8, I will apply here cos 30 base, BC upon hypotenuse AC. We know cos 30 value root 3 by 2. BC, I know the BC value, which is 8 upon AC hypotenuse. AC has to be found. We will send it to this side, and hence AC will be nothing but 16 by root 3. So once we get 16 by root 3 and AB as 8 by root 3, I will simply add AB and AC to get the whole tree height, and that will be, I'm writing here, height of the tree is 16 by 3 plus 8 by 3, 16 by root 3 plus 8 by root 3, that is 16 plus 8 divided by root 3, and hence we get 24 by root 3. So what I get? 8 root 3. That is the value of the height of the tree, 8 root 3 meters. Now again, here since it is not mentioned root 3 value or to find it in decimals, I'll leave it there only. Okay, that's very simple. Moving on, showing the whole solution. Height is 40. Wait a minute. Is it so? Okay, sorry. I had seen in the wrong question. So yes, BC is equals to 8 by root 3. BC, 8 by root 3. BD, we had found 16 by root 3. And if I find the whole thing, we get 24 root 8 root 3 is the final answer, what we got. Okay. Now, moving on to the next question. The next question is this, where it says a 7 meter long flagstaff is, misprint. A 7 meter long flagstaff is fixed on the top of a tower. Okay, fine. So make a tower. This is a tower. And here, there is a flagstaff. So, jhanda ucha rahe hamara, aisa kuch. Fine. From a point on the ground, the angle of elevation of the top and bottom of flagstaff means somewhere someone is standing on a ground here. He is looking at the top of the flagstaff and he is looking at the bottom of the flagstaff. Both positions. Okay. So, angle of elevation once he is making 60 and another time 45 means the larger angle this is 60 and the smaller angle this is 45. Fine. So find the height of the tower correct up to one place of decimal. So here we will have to put the value of root 3 or whichever root it comes. Okay. Let's name them A, B, C and this is D. So here if this is 90 degree and this is 45 degree, I'm not applying any trigonometry and we can do it with geometry also. If this is 90 degree, this is 45 degree, surely this will be also 45. 45, 45 isosceles. This, अरे, तुम क्यों बिगड़ गए? यार ये, okay, both of them 90 degrees, so CD is equals to BC. Now basically it is saying something, find the height of the tower, a 7 meter long flagstaff, so this value is given, okay, fine. But I got only one thing, that this, if this I assume this as base, this will be also B, means if I assume this as B, or instead of B, if you want, you can take it as X. If I assume this CD as X, BC will also be X. From geometry, we got it. You can even write it. Triangle BCD is isosceles. Hence, both of them X. Now, let's apply only one time trigonometry. Tan 60 degree. I'm just looking at 60. And tan 60, you know, again, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So, perpendicular is AC upon... Sorry, perpendicular upon base. I'm sorry. Perpendicular is AC and base is CD. So AC by CD. Tan 60 we know it is root 3. AC we know it's X plus 7, that is 7 plus X or X plus 7. AC upon base. Base is CD, so CD is X. Do the cross multiplication. It will have root 3X is equals to X plus 7. Put this X to this side. It will be root 3 minus 1 times X equals to 7. X is equals to 7 upon root 3 minus 1. You can put the value here, or I would suggest you to rationalize it. X, what we got. So, but what we have to find? Find the height of the tower. Okay, X we have to find. So, 7 upon, this is root 3 minus 1. Very easily you can rationalize it. Root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 plus 1. Denominator will have 2. So, I am writing directly the value. So, if you rationalize it, it will be 7 by 2 into root 3 plus 1. Now it will be easy for you to calculate 7 by 2. Don't put it 3.5, no. Into root 3, we got it 1.73. If I add 1 in this, it will be 2.73. Now cancel this. 2.73, it will be 1.8, if I'm not wrong, 1.865 something around. Okay. So 1.865 or 1.86 into 7. Now you can do. I'm just doing 7 5 35 3 3 8 45 5 4 8 56 0 6 7 6 13. So we have got 13.055, that is 13.06. So correct to two decimal. Okay, they have said only to one decimal place. You can get it 13.1. Simple. Okay. So yes, we got that answer. 13.1. Fine. Did you all understand it? Samajh mein aa gaya hoga? Fine. If you all understood that. Oh. Have we done some mistake? 9.6 aa raha hai. Ek bar dobara dekh lete hain. Ho sakta hai humne kuch galti ki ho. Please pay attention. So this will cancel it in. If I'm not wrong, 7 by 2 and it will cancel in 1.21 to 1 point. Okay, sorry, I put it 3. I'm very sorry. Wahan pe maine galti likh diya tha. I had put it there 8. I'm very sorry. 3 times and 1.13, so 6 times and then 5. 1.365, yes. So it is basically here you have 7 into 1.365. I'm sorry, ye galti kar diya tha maine. 7 5 35. Now you'll get 9.6. Calculate कर लेना, मेरे लिए आसान है, दिख रहा है आंसर. So please do the multiplication and be very conscious about this. It can give you some silly mistake also. So please don't get into that trap. Moving on, here is the next question which says, at a point A, 20 meter above the level of water in a lake. अरे wow. Again star mark question. Please mark it star. You all would have seen this question, I am damn sure. क्योंकि ये इतना famous question हो चुका है, हर बच्चा जानता है इसको और हर बच्चे को doubt होता है. Everyone has doubt in this question. So I'll just explain it to you. I have explained it earlier also in Umang series also, but here also I'll again explain it once more. And why I have taken it so many times, just because that it is important. Board asks this question. Okay, fine. So the question says that basically there is a lake. Okay, so my lake is straight, not looking like that, but anyways, I'll make it a straight lake. Okay, so there is this lake, just above a lake, some platform is there, from where someone is looking at the cloud, at a point A, 20 meter above the level of water in a lake. So this is 20 meter. From here, someone is observing a cloud. So there is a cloud here. Someone is observing that. So now someone is observing that, and this cloud will have a reflection in the water. Okay, this cloud has some height, so it will have a reflection in the water somewhere here. So this will have a reflection of the cloud in the water. Okay, because this water level will act as a plane mirror ki tarah hota hai na, to iske andar ab ha refraction aur reflection mat laga dena, theek hai? Refraction aur wo sare concepts mat laga dena, just apply simple reflection. Aur वैसे मैं आप बता दूं, physics ke hisab se 90 degree pe koi refraction nahi hota, wahan pe sirf reflection hota, theek hai? To reflection has a property ki image distance is equals to object distance. So if object is having some distance, say for example, मैं अगर इस distance को निकालना चाहूँ, तो ये तो 20 है, this is 20, because this is 20, तो this is also 20. And if I take this as x, तो ये पूरे cloud का length will be x plus 20 from the water level. So if this is x plus 20, you know this is also x plus 20. Image distance will be equal to object distance. ठीक है, तो नाउ द क्वेश्चन सेज द एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑफ द क्लाउड इज 30 डिग्री. तो ये एंगल तो 30 है, फाइन. द एंगल ऑफ डिप्रेशन ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द क्लाउड इन द लेक एट ए इज 60 डिग्री. मींस इसके रिफ्लेक्शन का एंगल ऑफ डिप्रेशन, मींस इफ समवन इज लुकिंग फ्रॉम हियर टू दिस क्लाउड, तो एंगल व्हाट ही इज मेकिंग इज 60 डिग्री. सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द डिस्टेंस ऑफ द क्लाउड फ्रॉम ए. क्लाउड फ्रॉम ए, the angle of depression of the reflection of the cloud in the lake at A is 60 degree. Okay, so this is your point A. तो यहां से लेके इसका distance बताना है, let it be B. AB का distance बताना है, okay? ठीक है, अच्छी बात है. तो first of all, let me assume this dotted line as B. ये length को मेरे को B मानने दो. मान लिया? So now if this is B, let's solve it. So first triangle, I am talking about tan 30 perpendicular x upon base. base is B. Perpendicular upon base, tan 30, we all know it is 1 by root 3. Cross multiplication, khatakhat, we will get B equals to root 3x. Root 3x is equals to B. This is the value. Okay, we got it. Fine. B equals to root 3x. Very good. Now, just apply the trigonometry in the second triangle. Downward triangle. Tan 60 degree. Laga do. So, tan 60 degree is equals to perpendicular. Dekho, 60 ke saamne. Opposite to this side. Perpendicular. Perpendicular is 20 plus x plus 20. Dekho, dhyan se. Please pay attention. X plus 20 plus 20. This whole is perpendicular. So, I will write perpendicular is x plus 40. Divided by B base. Divided by B base. Aagaya. Tan 60 value root 3 equals to x plus 40 divided by B. We have the B value root 3x. Dal the root 3x. Do the cross multiplication. So you will get 3x is equals to x plus 40. Solve it. You will get x is equals to 20. X ki value kya aagai? 20. Okay. We got x is equals to 20. Now, once we have got x is equals to 20, sara kaam hi ban gaya, 20, 20, 40. So, ye ho gaya 40, ye ho gaya 20. So, 20, 20, 40, 40, 40, 80. So, distance, 80 meters. Did you all understand it? Ye itna easy tha. Let me tell you, this is a very big solution given in the textbook. So, don't go through that. You can actually solve this question in so easy steps. In fact, mera kaam yahi hai. That is why I am taking your sprint. Meko agar bhai book wale, kyunki questions mein same bata raha hu, almost same, jo tumne kahin na kahin dekh rakhe hain. Alag isliye nahi bata raha hu because alag batane se koi fayda nahi. There is no use of making you understand some very difficult question, kyunki wo aayenge nahi exam mein. These questions will come in exam. So how to solve this in a very better method, in a very better approach, where you can save your time, save your space. Theek hai? So this is how you can do that. Moving on, this is a whole solution for it. H 20 meters aa gaya bade jaldi. Acha in logon ne bhi acha dimag lagaya. 40 meters dekho, hence the distance of the cloud from the lake is 40 meter. AC ki value 40 hai. To AC, acha AC chahiye tha kya isko? Okay, wait. H 20 wait a second, let me check it out. The angle, okay, at point A. I'm very sorry, मैंने point A किसी और को मान लिया, but not an issue. I guess तुम समझ तो गए होगे solve कैसे करना था. I'm sorry कि मैंने A किसी और point को मान लिया. I did not see this part. So basically you had to find this distance. But anyways, you have found this x was 20. This was already given 20 and we had to find this one. So हमने कुछ ऐसा किया था. So this was 20 and this was x plus 40. So if 20 again, so this is also 40. We have found all these values. This is 30 degree, this is 60 degree. I guess you can find it very easily. Okay? 30 hai, ye 20 hai, so you have to find the hypotenuse. So if you have to find the hypotenuse, just apply the appropriate t ratio. Sine will be applicable and you will get the value. Ye 20 hai, to laga hi lo, main likh hi deta hu yaar. A aur yahan pe cloud tha, C maan lo. So I'm just applying sine 30. Sine 30 kya hoga? Perpendicular 20 upon hypotenuse AC. If we have to find the AC value, sine 30 kya hota hai? This is 1 by 2. Cross multiply kar do. AC will get 40. That is what we have to find. Distance of cloud from A point. Okay? Chalo. If you all understood, let's move on. Here's the next question then. Solution to dekhi liya. A moving boat observed from the top of a 150 meter high cliff moving away from the cliff. The angle of depression of that boat changes from 60 degree to 45 degree in 2 minutes. Very good question. An outstanding question. Again, isko bhi double star mark kar lo. Because this is also very favorite and HOTS question of the boats. Chalo, dekhte hain. 150 meter high. Bana do. Boat. Being observed, a boat. Yahan kahi boat hai. This is a lake. Yahan kahi boat hai. Okay, this is a boat. Now boat is moving. So actually the question is saying angle of depression. Angle of depression means ye wala angle. So yaar ye wala angle bar bar le usse better yehi le lete na. Because if this is 60 degree, surely this is also going to come to 60. So let's remove this. So what the question is saying, that boat is moving away. Kahin to likha tha, kahan likha tha? Haan. moving away from the cliff. So if boat is initially here, after some time boat will be here. Okay, after some time boat will be here. Fine. So from this point, if someone looks at the boat, angle of elevation changes from 60 to 45, means this time this angle is 45. Okay, in 2 minutes. So basically from here to here, the distance has been covered in 2 minutes only. So if I name this A, B, C, D. So CD distance has been covered in 2 minutes. That is what the question is saying. And now we have to find the speed of the boat. Okay, let's do that. So first of all, we'll find BC. Okay, so let's find BC. Tan 60 laga do. Perpendicular upon base BC. Tan 60 ki value, we know it is root 3. Sorry. This is BC. Tan 60, we know it is root 3. Root 3. Cross multiply. BC equals to 150 by root 3. Root 3, root 3 cancel hoga. You will get it 50 root 3. Theek hai. Ye value to aa gayi. Now we have to find AD. So AD finding is not required because it is very easy. Why? Please pay attention. You are again able to see that triangle ABD is isosceles. Hai kya? Isosceles. So if it is isosceles 45 degree, surely this is also 45 degree, and hence I can write AB is equals to BD. AB is equals to BD. Both of them should be equal to 150 meters. Okay. So I have got BD, I have got BC. What I need? I need CD. I'll write CD equals to BD minus BC. And what is BD? BD is 150 minus what is BC? BC is 50 root 3. Let's calculate it. Simple. If you want to calculate it, so this distance you are going to find, 50 will be common. And you will get 3 minus root 3. 3. Arre, chodo yahi likh deta hu. You will get it 50 common, 3 minus root 3. Now this is the distance of CD, but we have been asked the speed of the boat. So time taken for covering the CD is 2 minutes. So distance by time, answer, speed. So I'll just write that speed here. That speed of the boat is CD distance divided by 2 minutes. So CD is 50 times 3 minus root 3 divided by 2 minutes, or you can put it 120 seconds, whatever you wish for. So, agar main minute mein dalunga 2, so I will write 25 times 3 minus root 3 meters per minute. Unit zarur likhna, please, otherwise galat ho sakta hai. Meters per minute will be the final unit, and you can write that, not an issue. ठीक है? Or if you want to change it to meter per second, go ahead, put 120, that is also fine. ठीक है? That will be the answer. Showing you the whole solution, देखो, 60-45, diagram is same, 60 and 45, and hence if you solve it, you will get boat 25, अच्छा ये x है, speed of the boat, okay, wait a minute, x, 2x, okay. So this is the value, CD is 2x. CD, they have assumed 2x. So if they have assumed CD as 2x, the value of x is 25, 3 minus root 3. So if you will multiply 2, we were also getting 50 times 3 minus root 3. That is fine. And then speed of the boat will be divided by the time. So that time is, they have also taken meter per minute, not an issue. So same thing, meter per minute. 2, if you divide it by 2, that is fine. Meter per minute, okay? This is the speed which we are also getting, meter per minute. In case if you want in kilometer per hour, so that is the method, okay? Now moving on, and let me tell you, it is not written in the question, so it's not mandatory that you should write it in that way. You can write it in any way, whatever you want. Fit, okay? Moving on, this is the next question. Question says, two posts are k meter apart and the height of one is double that of the other. Okay, two posts. So means roughly two towers. So one is h meters, another is 2h meters. Fine. And they are k meters apart. Okay, that is also fine. If the midpoint of the line segment joining the feet, midpoint means here, An observer finds the angle of elevation of their tops to be complementary. Complementary means if one is theta, another is 90 minus theta. So from here, if someone looks at the top, so say for example, this angle is theta. So if someone looks at this top, this angle he finds 90 minus theta. Complementary angles, angle of elevation. Then find the height of the shortest post, means find the value of h. Okay. And this is the midpoint, so I guess you all will be getting that this k will be divided into two parts. This will be k by 2 and this will be k by 2. Isn't it? Now let's apply trigonometry, isn't it? Simple hai yaar, trigonometry apply kar do. To agar trigonometry apply karte hain, to kya milega? Dekho, batata hun. Tan theta perpendicular upon base upar bhejo. So you will get 2h by k. This is tan theta. ठीक है, 2h by k. Now second part, if we take the second part, so that is tan 90 minus theta. Tan 90 minus theta, it is perpendicular upon base again, because tan is always perpendicular by base. So tan 90 minus theta perpendicular. What is perpendicular? 2h upon base. Base what is? K by 2. Fine. But here tan 90 minus theta, what is the value of tan 90 minus theta? Bata do. Cot theta, I guess sare jante ho. And cot theta, don't you think iska reciprocal hoga? So I'm writing here, cot theta is k by 2h, which is equals to, here if you will form, you will get 4h by k. Yaha se what you get, you will get blah blah, something something. So I am just doing k square equals to 8h square. That means k is equals to 2 root 2h. We have got a relation between k and 2 root 2h. Theek hai, fine. So we have got k as 2 root 2h. Rather, we have to find height. So height is h. So if I have to find h, I will send this 2 root 2 to the denominator. So I'll write h is equals to k by 2 root 2. And that will be my final answer. Now don't think, sir, here we did not get the numerical value. Let me tell you, here we cannot get the numerical value because not even a single numerical value is mentioned in the question itself. Rather, in the question, k is mentioned, k meters apart. So this means question itself wants you to find the value in terms of k. So height of the smallest post will be k upon 2 root 2. That will be the final value. I hope you all are understanding. Okay. Chalo. If you all understood that, so that will be the final answer. Moving on. So the solution would be something looking like this only. Similar. K by 2 root 2 or k root 2 by 4. Whatever you wish for, both of them will be the height. And if you all understood, so that was all for today's session. We had a very, we had a very beautiful session, isn't it? So again, here is this homework for all of you. Aja. Here is a homework. Looks like kafi bada hai, isn't it? Lekin utar lo. Please take a snapshot of this homework so that you can solve it and put the answers in the comment box. Now, please do put it in comment box because I really like your comments. I really love them. I spend almost half an hour reading them and it's like super great. And why comments are more important? Because actually, comments are those things with which I am able to actually connect with you. So see, what happens na, that if I make these videos for all of you, just keeping in that mind that okay, I have to make a video, then I'll not be so much energetic. Itna enthusiasm aayega hi nahi. Kyunki mereko lagega main pata nahi kiske liye kar raha hu. But jab tum comment karte ho, when you guys comment, to aisa lagta haan, koi sun raha hai. There are some people who are getting benefited because of this. And in fact, there are some people who really want it. Ye main bina purpose ke liye nahi kar raha hu. Ye feeling aati hai andar se. Aur ye feeling sabse pyari wali feeling hoti hai. Dekho, ek baat to hai, teacher only is, what you can say, teacher has hunger only for one thing. That is the gratitude and the love from the students. वो मिल रहा है, बस अपना सब सेट है और कोई टेंशन है नहीं. टीचर इंसान बड़ा मतलब अच्छा इंसान होता है. ओके, तो ये आपका सोल्यूशन है. एंड प्लीज राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट बॉक्स इफ यू आर लाइकिंग द वीडियो, प्लीज लाइक इट, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू लाइक इट. और शेयर जरूर कर देना दूसरे लोगों के लिए, क्योंकि दूसरों का भी भला हो, तुम्हारे ही हाथों थोड़ा हो जाए, isn't it? चलो कंप्लीट करने के पहले some beautiful lines for all of you, isn't it? As what we do, जिंदगी कांटे का सफर है, जिंदगी कांटे का सफर है, हौसला इसकी पहचान है, रास्ते पर तो सभी चलते हैं, जो रास्ता बनाए वही इंसान है, समझे मेरे प्यारे बच्चों? So moving on, this is the whole schedule for the day, for what we have done. This is for the next coming days. So we have completed applications of trigonometry. Again, tomorrow we'll be starting with the circles part. So yes, we will be there. And if you want to download the notes, whatever I have taught you, so you can download the notes going to this app, download the Vedantu learning app and you'll get everything there. And in case if you want to buy the course, only one single chapter specific course, you can buy it on vdnt.in/ytmicro, only chapter specific small courses. Use the code HPMIC for getting the discount. Okay, this is a whole subscription mode also. Go to this website, you will be able to apply this code and get the whole year long subscription in this price only. So that was all for today's session, guys. It's time to say a very goodbye to all of you. If you haven't liked the video, please like it right now. And in case if you want to communicate with me, this is my mail ID. Go ahead and write it down to me. So see you guys in the next session tomorrow at the same time. Till then, bye bye. Take care and good night. Bye bye.